It's lovely to be here. It's my second reading for Poets and Players. Last time was a long time ago for Linda. I'm going to read entirely new work from my next book, out next year, and it's called Mama Amazonica. It is for my mother, who suffered from quite severe mental illness all her life, and it's set in a psychiatric ward and in the Amazon rainforest. Mama Amazonica. Picture my mother as a baby, afloat on a water lily leaf, a name tag round her wrist, Victoria Amazonica. There are rapids ahead the doctors call mania. For now, all is quiet. She's on a deep sleep cure. A sloth clings to the cecropia tree, a jaguar sniffs the bank. My mother on her green raft, its web of ribs, its underside of spines. I'll sing her a lullaby, tell her how her quilted crib has been known to support a carefully balanced adult. My newborn mama, washed clean by the drugs, a caiman basking beside her. All around her, the other patients snore, while her eyes open their mandorlas. Now, my mother is turning into the flower. She's heating up. By nightfall, her bud opens its petals to release the heady scent of pineapple. How the jungle stories stir in the breeze from the window behind her. She hears the first roar of the howler monkey, then the harpy eagle's swoop, the crash through galleries of leaves, the sudden snatch, then the silence in the troop. Haloperidol, phenobarbital, they've tried them all, those witch doctors, and still she leaps up in her green nightie and fumbles to make tea, slopping the cup over her bed like the queen of rain. See her change from nightclub singer to giant bloom in the glow of the nightlight, a mezzo-soprano under the red moon. She's drawing the night-flying scarabs into the crucible of her mind. Over and over they land and burrow into her lace. By dawn, she closes her petals. All the next day, the beetles stay inside her. The males mount the females, their claws hooked round forewings. There is pollen to feed on, no need to leave their pension. Night after night, my mother replays this, how the white lily of her youth let that scarab of a man scuttle into her floral chamber before she could cry no. She flushes a deep carmine, too dirty to get up, and her face releases them. The petals of her cheeks spring open. Black beetles crawl out up the ward walls. Jaguar girl. Her gaze is tipped with curare. Her face, farouche from the kids' asylum where ice baths failed to tame her. Her claws are crescent moons sharpened on lightning. She swims through the star splinters of a mirror and emerges snarling, my weir mama. She's a rainforest in a straitjacket. Where she leaps, the sky comes alive, unleashed from its bottle. My mother, trying to conceal her lithium tremor as she carries the Amazon on her back, her rosettes of rivers and oxbow lakes, her clouds of chattering caciques, hyacinth macaws, her flocks of archangels. Her own tongue is a hive that stings yet pollinates all the orchids of the forest. Her ears prick to the growl of roots under concrete, the purr of plants growing. My animal mother, shaman's bitch, a highway bulldozed through her brain, shapeshifter into a trembling rabbit whenever I'm scared of her. She who's had electric eels pressed to her scalp can vanish into backwards where no one can reach her. I'm trying to sew her back together, to make a patchwork of gold dust and ghost vines, a sylvan pelt of torn down trees, the shadow dance of leaves on litter. I'm trying to conjure her in her zoo cage as the doctor comes running to dart her. She'll come back later. In the Peruvian mountains, various things are mummified, and some of those creatures that are mummified are macaws. Macaw mummy. Soon they will unwrap her. Soon it will be over. There's only 500 years to go. What did he put in her drink? Whatever it was has given her a dream she can't escape from, however much she wills the bandages to unwind, her eyes to open, however much she promises never to cry again. Her scarlet feathers lie bravely under the ice of his deep frozen duvet. Bandaged Bambi. 1. Bandaged. In the kitchen, with the one gas ring she has to learn to cook on, a fawn is helping, its body tightly bandaged. 2. Bambi. Her right leg is in a splint, as is her left elbow, and he's bandaged up her chest. She wonders where he's put her breasts now that she's a fawn. Only her rump, with its spots like hail, is exposed to the air. She remembers the hailstorm, a mirror shattering, and slivers of ice snaking towards her. Precious Goliath Beetle. Beetles with intricate cameras mounted on their carapaces record every harm that comes to her in diamantine detail. The birth of Jaguar Girl. You come out hissing, bite off your own cord, gobble the afterbirth, and lick me off your fur. You stumble into the garden to chew ayahuasca leaves, get so high your tails are fer-de-lance to play catch with, your rosettes tarantulas pouncing through sunlight. Your new eyes are blue as morpho butterflies drunk on fermented fruit. When the doctors catch you, you leap up the buttress roots of their trousers. They press a black scorpion against your chest to listen to your heart, that spider monkey swinging through your ribs. You barely last the day before they drug you, my cub mama, fire girl, too dangerous for the ward. Soon your mouth fills with vampire bats and burrowing owls. Every time they sedate you, I have to carry you in my belly again, pad on all fours over the pantanal of the corridors. Months I grow heavy with your visions, until it's time to give birth to my jaguar beast, she who kills with one bound, who claws her way out. Change of scene now to the sea. I'm on a residency in Cumbria at the moment, and I'm based on St. Bees on the beach. My mother's dressing gown, day. Blue silk that fell from her in swathes. Blue over the shore of her body. She was always suffering bilious attacks, sawing brittle glass ampoules from a box lined with tissue that fluttered like water at the edge of a rock pool. I'd peep in and see the jagged necks of the vials, their heads cut off. When she approached me, her pace was tidal. By the time she arrived, her chignon would have worked itself loose like a fiery sunset around the orb of her face, followed by her crashing hem, the barnacles and strands of kelp. I backed away from her caresses, afraid I'd drown. When the edge of her sleeve brushed against me, I was stung by a ray. If the front of her gown fell open, instinct stopped me from seeking her nipple, told me her breasts teemed with hungry anemones. Her house had tide lines strewn with pill bottles, all the debris that fell from her pockets as the doctors tried out new drugs on her. As if a woman could gather her skirts and drag the whole sea up with her while her head disintegrates in clouds, so my mother lay like an ocean in the hospital, surrounded by nurses who tried to hold her as she thrashed and, under their gaze, burst into flame, an oil spill blooming on her skin. Who had lit the fuse? She emitted a continuous roar, like a glass kiln yanked open. So they increased her dose, fed intravenously until she was calm, wrapped in a tight sheet, her face peering out from one of those ice holes seals claw at to come up for air. What I now know is that the drugs were ulcerating her intestines, that in the theater, surgeons mobbed her like gulls, stripped out lengths of her gut with their beaks. The hummingbird whisperer. Let the surgeon who opens my mother be tender as a hummingbird whisperer. Let him pull back the walls of her abdomen and see uncut jewels under his knife. Let him have a pet name for each part. his hummers, oiseau mouche, his beige flores, colibris, his almost extinct hooded visor bearer. Let him handle them with crystal instruments, easing droppers down each throat to check their stomach contents are rich in micro insects and spider eggs, the nectar of never before seen orchids. Let him soothe them as their black eyes turn to watch him. Let them be so calm he can unwrap their dressings to measure their wings and wipe blood from their feathers. Let him clean each gorget and crest so the colors shine with health. Let my mother's dryads and sylphs, hermits and incas, her sapphires, her ruby topaz moustiques, practice flying again, forwards, backwards, on the spot, hovering and hyperactive to the last in their silk compartments. Let their dissolvable straitjackets drop off at the appointed time. Let the man who closes my mother's body check that each flight feather is intact and return her to the recovery room to land safely. Thank you very much.